The poet William Wordsworth attended school in this schoolhouse in Hawkshead. William had been sent to Hawkshead to attend school away from the town where he was born, Cockermouth, which is a much larger city.
Graffiti that you can see on the old woodwork, this was tolerated. There was no punishment for it. And the first mistake the school made was giving every boy a penknife to sharpen his quill.
Exactly. Yeah.
And it was predominantly middle class and wealthy boys. Sisters of these boys would have been wealthy and they would have had a governess or a tutor at home, but no school for girls. They weren't worth educating them.
No.
This is Dove Cottage, the cottage in Grasmere where Wordsworth lived with his sister Dorothy, and then after his marriage with his wife Mary, their children, and lots of visitors. Dove Cottage is a small house that was once a pub. There are essentially two rooms upstairs and two rooms and a kitchen downstairs. One of the upstairs windows was Wordsworth's study. It was one of the largest rooms in the house and had one of the best views looking out over the lake. Wordsworth used it as a study, even though they were quite crowded in the rest of the house. Dorothy Wordsworth lived here with her brother, William, while she wrote her journals. In those journals, we see many lines that Wordsworth later echoed in his own poetry. The little building where William taught school is now a bake shop that sells gingerbread. this is the parish church in Grasmere, where Wordsworth is buried. After Wordsworth became poet laureate, he and his family moved to this house, Rydalmount. As you can see, it's much larger, much grander, and is set in an absolutely beautiful setting overlooking Rydal Water, one of the lakes. This is Wordsworth's home, Rydalmount, and the beautiful gardens that surround it. Just below the house is a field that Wordsworth and his wife bought for their daughter Dora. Dora died as a young adult, and Wordsworth and his wife planted the field in daffodils in her memory.
Where you can sit and admire the beautiful view. From here, Wordsworth could sit and overlook the lake called Rydal Water and write.
Were you able to?
One of the primary characteristics of Romanticism is love of nature, and when we see the beautiful surroundings Wordsworth lived in, it's not surprising that he wrote so beautifully about nature.